Jesus said in the end times, the world will experience birth pains before the great and terrible day of the Lord, before Jesus comes back with power and glory to execute judgment upon this world. Now, it does say that there will be wars, there will be famines, there will be natural disasters, there will be pestilences, there will be diseases that will plague this earth in great horror. It says that men's hearts will fail them for fear of what is coming upon the earth. However, it doesn't just say that they will come, because I know a lot of people say, well, you know, earthquakes always happened, and we always had pestilence and plagues and pandemics. The key here is that not only will these things come upon the earth, but they will be like birth pains, okay? I know a lot of people say, oh yeah, we've always had earthquakes for thousands of years. There's been pandemics, there's been earthquakes, and so on and so forth. Okay, that's true. But Jesus made it very clear by saying that it would be like birth pains. What are birth pains like? Well, they start out slow. You have a pain, and it might be a couple hours before you have another pain, and then a couple hours before you have another pain. But they get more frequent, and they get more intense. Sometimes there is, you know, an inconsistency in birth pains. For example, there might be birth pains every 12 minutes, and then there'll be a relief of 20 minutes. And then it'll start again, 12 minutes, then it'll go to 10 minutes, then, you know, 5, 3, 2, 1, and there we go. We have the baby. Let's look at history. Let's look at the past 2,000 years since Jesus made that prophecy. Now, here's a chart of the pandemics that have occurred since the time of Jesus. These are the pandemics listed here that have killed over 500,000 people. In the second century, there was one, the Antonine Plague. There were several hundred years before the next one. In the sixth century, there was the Plague of Justinian. Again, there was a space of several hundred years before the 14th century, there was the Black Death. Again, well, not quite as many years, but still several hundred years before the 19th century, all of a sudden now we've got two plagues, two of the pandemics. That's the third cholera pandemic and the Russian flu pandemic. Then in the 20th century, all of a sudden we've got four. Okay? See, look at the increase in frequency. Four all of a sudden. And they are listed here. Now, just within the first 20 years of the 21st century, the HIV/AIDS pandemic was at its peak. And also now we have, and we are in the middle of, the coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic, which we still do not know how many will die, but I wouldn't doubt it would be far beyond this number. So you see here, these are just like birth pains. One here, one here, one here, pick up speed, and pick up speed and intensity. These are the earthquake statistics from the 16th century. One in the 17th century, four in the 18th century, eight, little bit of a let up here, and that's typical in birth pains, in the 19th century, seven in the 20th century, 10. And so far, just in the first 20 years, okay, this is, I mean, this could be like 30, 40, 50 for all we know, and by the time the, you know, 2100 comes around. It could be 100 for all we know. But you see the pattern here. It's getting worse, more frequency. And by the way, again, these are the earthquakes that are greater than 8.5 in magnitude. So you see here, we are right on track when it comes to the birth pains that the earth is experiencing. They will get more frequent. They will get more intense. Coronavirus will go away. At least the major scare of it will go away. But something else will come in the near future. And that is according to Scripture.